When we start the application, the first thing we see is this main window that has on its sides several different areas called panels. Let's open the panel settings and see what we have here. We don't have sections yet, so no sections panel for us just now. Next down is the current section panel, which is this yellow guy right here, containing the links to our metadata objects. To the left we have the tools panel with a fixed list of the system functions. And at the bottom we have this gray area that shows the hidden panels. We can make them visible by dragging and dropping them to the any side of the main window. So let's see what exactly it's all about. This is the favorites panel. I'm dropping it here. And now I can start marking things as my favorites. Lists, specific data objects, comments, pretty much anything. After I'm done marking, I can use these links as shortcuts to my favorite places in the app. The links can be renamed, moved up and down, marked as the most favorite, deleted, etc. Next one is the Open Items panel. Let's drop it down here. And now we can see all open forms and tabs, so it's easier to switch between them. The last one is the History panel. It remembers everything we opened recently, so you can come back to it when you need. If I don't want any of these guys, I can drop them back to this gray area and they will disappear from the main window. As a developer, I can set up the default set of panels I want my users to see. It's done here from the client's application interface. I always prefer to see the open forms as tabs, so I'm adding this panel to the default view. And these are my open item tabs. As we already saw, the default view can be easily changed by a user. And, of course, every user will have their own personal and independent set of settings. Now let's talk the sections panel. The idea behind this is that you might and you probably will have too many comments to fit into this rather small area. This is where the subsystems come for the rescue, working as a kind of folders for the comments in this section. Let me create a new subsystem called Lists and place all the catalogs here. I also want all the documents in another subsystem. When I try to save the application, the platform says that there are possible errors. Namely, there are some metadata objects that are not included into any subsystem. Okay, fair point. Let's add another subsystem called Other and put these two guys in there. Okay, now the app is running successfully and here are the comments grouped by the subsystems. By the way, this is the same section panel we already mentioned. Now, when it's filled with subsystems, we can see it and place it anywhere in the main window. What now catch my eyes here are these bullet points. I'm honestly not a big fan of. The good news is that we can replace them with any pictures we want. I'm just opening each subsystem and load the picture I want from the disk. And this is already looking better, right? I'd also like to replace this quick menu icon. I mean, it's cute and everything, it just has nothing to do with my convenience store. So I'm going right here and replacing it with the more appropriate one. Note that when we run the app, these pictures do not get loaded from the files they used to live in. They now live right in the app, here in the common pictures, so they always go with the app whenever it goes. Okay, now, what's the deal with this empty quick menu folder? This is not really a subsystem, it's just a group you place all your frequently used commands to. We didn't really discuss what the commands are, so let's just leave it empty for now. We'll get back to it pretty soon, I promise.